It's a short presentation on therapeutic communities. It's quick overview on a therapeutic community, the principles of therapeutic community. I'll move on to perspective of therapeutic community with basic assumptions. And therapeutic community as an approach and its unique concept of community as a method. Also with the basic components of therapeutic community model, along with the modifications or adaptations to the therapeutic community programs as such and its effectiveness. So the term therapeutic community first appeared in the literature when Maxwell Jones, 1953, wrote the book called Social Psychiatry. He is the first person who has put it in the literature, the therapeutic community as such. Therapeutic community is a form of moral treatment based on Philippines' principles of human and kind treatment. Therapeutic community is a structured method and environment for changing human behavior in the context of community life and responsibility. Skinner defines therapeutic community as a scientific structuring of the environment in order to affect behavioral changes and to improve the psychological health and functioning of the individual. The Australian Therapeutic Community Association describes therapeutic community as a treatment facility in which the community itself, through the self-help and mutual support, and is the principal means for promoting personal change. In a therapeutic community, residents and staff participate in the management and operation of the community, contributing to a psychologically and physically safe learning environment where change can occur. In a therapeutic community, there is a focus on social, psychological, and behavioral dimensions of substance use, with the use of community to heal individuals emotionally and support the development of behaviors, attitudes, and values of healthy living. Few years later, Maxwell Jones pioneered therapeutic communities in psychiatry hospital. The drug-free residential programs for substance abuse started emerging. Even though the term therapeutic community evolved in hospital settings, the two models, the therapeutic community in hospital settings and the drug-free residential programs for substance use, arose independently. Coming to therapeutic communities for substance abuse, which has emerged in the late 1950s as a self-help alternative to existing conventional treatments. The people who were behind it were recurring substance dependent people. And although its modern antecedents can be traced to Alcoholic Anonymous and Sign-On, contemporary therapeutic communities for addiction are sophisticated human service institutions. Today, in general, the label therapeutic community is generic, describing a variety of long-term and short-term residential and non-residential programs that serve a wide spectrum of clients with substance use disorders. Therapeutic communities are a common form of long-term residential treatment for substance use disorders. Therapeutic community is an effective and cost-effective treatment, particularly for substance users with serious social and psychological problems in addition to their substance use. Principles of the therapeutic community as such aims at open and direct communication, active participation, and democratic system of governing, with the governing system offering frequent opportunities to participate in administrative and therapeutic opportunities by both inmates and the staff. And the opportunity is provided to participate in the decision-making process as well, which makes them believe that they are capable of making decisions about their daily living. Coming to the perspective of therapeutic community in relation to addiction as such, the therapeutic community perspective or the theory shapes its program model and its unique approach as community as the method. The perspective consists of four interrelated views of the substance use disorder, the individual, the recovery process, and the healthy living. The view of the disorder is physical dependency is seen in the context of individual's psychological status and lifestyle rather than the disease as such. Here, the problem is the person and not the substance use. The disorder affecting almost all areas of functioning namely cognitive, medical, behavioral, emotional, and social. The next one is view of the person, how the therapeutic community views the person as such. The view distinguishes along the dimension of psychological and social deficits rather than the drug usage pattern as such. The psychological and social deficits, common psychological and social deficits, are low frustration tolerance, low self-esteem, poor impulse control, unrealistic expectations, difficulty in coping, problems with authority and responsibility, and feelings of guilt. The view of recovery, the therapeutic community looks the global changes as the in lifestyle and identity or the treatment goals of it. And it looks recovery as a developmental learning, and self-help and mutual help are the essential components of the recovery. So the last view of right living is the basic or the essential component is beliefs and values are essential components of this view, is about the truth and honesty of the person, the responsibility at personal, responsibility as personal as well as the social level, the better work ethics, focusing more on here and now rather than past, learning to learn, and the community involvement. Skinner identifies 7 basic assumptions for therapeutic communities. As such, the health in each individual is to be realized and encouraged to grow. That is, identify the strengths and facilitate those strengths of the individual. Every interaction is an opportunity for therapeutic interaction. Whatever the interaction happens between the individuals or between the environment as such in a therapeutic community provides an opportunity for an intervention. The participant owns his or her own environment in the community. He owns his or her own behavior. Therapeutic community assumes that peer pressure is the useful and powerful tool to bring the change in the individual. Inappropriate behaviors are dealt with as they occur, when they occur. The basic assumption is to avoid restriction and punishments, even though in difficult cases timeouts are allowed. Coming to the unique concept of therapeutic community as an approach, community as a method has been proposed as the unique concept. Even though the community as doctor has a new perspective has been, the parallel concept has been proposed by Rappaport in 1960. The community as method proposes the purposive use of the peer community to facilitate social and psychological change in individuals and to use the community to change themselves. Every activity are designed to produce therapeutic and educational change in the individual. And all the participants who are interacting with the community as such are the mediators of these changes for themselves as well as for the others. Coming to the elements of community as the method, there has been 9 use or 9 elements has been defined by De Leon. So the first is use of participant roles. Use of participant roles stresses on the active participation. So all the participants within the community are mandatorily have to participate in every activity which is designed to make a change in the individual. So no one is allowed to be a spectator in the community as such. The second concept is important as because it allows the membership feedback. The primary source of instruction and support for the individual for a change is his peer membership. So the observations and the authentic reactions to the individual on his behavior in the community brings about a change. The third element is the use of membership as the role model. Everyone strives to be the role model, even though the education training and the therapeutic activities are used in collective formats to bring about the change, which is taken as fourth element. Use of shared norms and values. everyone will share the community norms and values we are going to, I'm going to talk in the latter slide. Use of structure and systems, the environment as such, the community, the therapeutic community as such is allowing the opportunity for every individual to participate in the day-to-day operations of the facility, right from cleaning till they go back to the bed, which gives them opportunity for them to interact with every individual as well as with the environment, which happens in the social context and through the social intercourse. As the principal mentioned, the open communication is encouraged, and the use of or the relationship with particular individuals or with particular staff or with the other members are encouraged. And the TC has its own language. Coming to the values, values form the guiding principles for the community and as such could be compared to the community concerns. They define what is good and what is bad. In most communities, values are primarily unwritten and not transmitted through the institutions of community or religious institutions. In therapeutic communities, values are spoken as concepts. There are 10 values which has been identified as core values, which has been selected by members of over 100 therapeutic communities across sectors and client groups. Those 10 core values are attachment, because healthy attachment is a developmental requirement for all human beings and should be seen as a basic human right. Second one is containment, which talks about the self and supportive environment required for an individual to develop, to grow, or to support himself for a change. Third is respect. People need to feel respected and valued by others to be healthy. Everybody is unique and nobody should be defined or described by their problems alone. Communication. All behavior has a meaning and represents communication which deserves understanding. There is an interdependence between the members. The personal well-being arises from one's ability to develop relationship which recognizes mutual needs of the community members. The next is relationship. Understanding how you relate to the others and how others relate to you leads to better intimate family, social and working relationships. As the components is the participation, the active participation, ability to influence one's environment and relationship is necessary for personal well-being. Being involved in decision making is required for shared participation, responsibility and ownership. And as such, the individuals have to respect the process. It's not always a right answer, and it is often useful for individuals, groups and larger organizations to reflect rather than react immediately. The balance, positive and negative experience are necessary for healthy development of individuals, groups and the community. Responsibility, each individual has the responsibility to the group and the group in turn to the individual. So coming to the components of the program model, social organization. Social organization involves the community environment, community separativeness and the community activities, which gives a democratic style of functioning. As I said earlier, it is like daily regimen is planned by the participants themselves. They have the democratic process of selecting the list of activities right from the bed to the bed. The community separativeness talks about the community being separated from the other treatment providing agency or the institute, naming separately, and the community environment allows, like, it ensures the philosophy or the components of the treatment to be displayed on regular places. It should be in a formalized way. Peers as role models is the next component. As said earlier, it is like everyone strives to be the role models. here the role models are like whoever behaves or demonstrates the behavior, the way the community values and teachings are, they act as role models. Obviously, the community encourages everyone to be the role models. And the next component is staff as rational authorities. The staff should behave as a community member rather than a service provider or a treatment provider. They should act as a rational authorities, facilitators, guide, and a mutual helper to bring in the change in the individual. The next component is structure day. The structure day, we'll talk about the daily regimen as such. The structure day involves the daily operations of the facility. Every individual is involved in the daily operations, right from cleaning the facility, meal, cooking the meal, serving the meal, maintenance of the facility as such, other administrative and educative activities of the program as such. The structured activity or the structured day actually counters the negative thinking and boredom of the individual, also counters the factors which are predisposing the substance use. It also facilitates the learning self-structure, self-learning, time management, and how to plan and meet the goals of his own thing. Next is the phase as the component. Phase, there is an incremental phase in the program as such. As the phase involves, there is an incremental learning in the individual to bring about the change. Coming to occupation as therapy and education, which provides an opportunities for skill and development, which fosters self-examination and personal growth of the individual. This also, the last component is about the continuum of the care. Even after the completion of therapeutic community, once he completes the last phase of the community, it is the last phase allows them to prepare for the continuum of the care. The therapeutic communities have a recovery orientation focusing on the whole person and overall lifestyle changes, not simply abstinence from the drug use. The orientation acknowledges the chronic relapsing nature of the substance use disorder and holds the view that lapses are opportunities for learning and not as a problem. Recovery is seen as a gradual ongoing process of a cognitive change which allows lapses as a process of change. Therapeutic communities encourage participants to examine their personal behavior to help them become more pro-social and engage in right living, considered to be based on honesty, taking responsibility, hard work, and willingness to learn. As they progress through the stages of recovery, they assume greater responsibility, greater personal and social responsibilities in the community. The goal of the therapeutic community participant to leave, the goal is for a therapeutic community participant to leave the program not only as a sober person, but also as an employed individual or the person who takes training in a school or any educational institution. It is not that uncommon to progress in their recovery to take on leadership and staff roles within the same therapeutic community itself. The therapeutic communities use a highly regulated daily regimen with clearly stated expectations for behavior and psychological and behavioral rewards for working hard and meeting expectations. Disciplinary sanctions for violations help to maintain structure for therapeutic community participants and staff and ensure the participants' lives are orderly and productive. Occupation is a distinct component of the therapeutic community approach. Each participant is assigned particular tasks that help him or teach him the responsibility and the importance of work, respect, and self-reliance. The vocational and educational activities which occur in the group sessions and provide work communication and interpersonal skills training. The therapeutic community rules has an explicit purpose and implicit aim. The purpose ensures safety and health of the community, and the aim is to train the members in the basic tenets of the human interaction within a community. The rules creates the structure that ensures that members understand the behaviors that are approved and disapproved by the therapeutic community. The daily regimen involves the activities such as group discussion with peers, individual counseling, learning through collective format, which is the morning meetings, seminars, confrontation, games, role playing. Community meetings review the goals, procedures, and functioning. Individual and group work in therapeutic communities focus on changing negative patterns of thought and behavior and building on self-efficacy, so participants learn to think of themselves as the primary driver of their own change process, be accountable for their behaviors, and to set goals for their own personal well-being, positive participation in the broader community, and life after living in treatment. To help people identify, express, and manage their feelings in appropriate and positive ways. In group activities, participants focus on behaving in ways that are acceptable in the community rather than how they behave in the past. There are three stages, which is induction, the stage two talks about the treatment, and the stage three talks about re-entry. The individual assimilates in the therapeutic community and is expected to fully participate in every activity of the therapeutic community. Immersion into the drug-free community is meant to disrupt the individual's identification with ties to his or her previous drug-using life and replace this with new affiliations, pro-social attitudes, behaviors, and responsibilities, and increase his or her knowledge about the nature of addiction. The second phase talks about evidence-based behavioral treatments, including such as motivational interviewing or CBT to facilitate the process of change and enhance the community as method approach. The overall goal is to change attitudes and behavior, instill hope, and foster emotional growth, including self-management ability. Other therapeutic activities, including relevant interventions, address the person's social, educational, vocational, familial, and psychological needs. Community as method is an essential and defining approach of therapeutic community, in which participating in a mutual help community drives individual to change and attainment of his or her own therapeutic goals. In the re-entry stage, the participant prepares himself to leave the therapeutic community and for a successful re-entry into the larger community by seeking employment or making educational or training arrangements with therapeutic community's help. As the recovery is an ongoing process, aftercare services are arranged to help individuals to maintain the changes they have made during the treatment. All the participants are strongly encouraged to work in self-help groups after completion of the program, like AA. Coming to the modifications and adaptations the therapeutic community gone through over the years, the clinical requirements and the funding realities of the modern day has pushed therapeutic community to change itself, to adapt itself to the needs. It has become more comprehensive. Historically speaking, the therapeutic communities are completely against the medical model. They never allowed even methadone maintenance inside the therapeutic community. Over the period of last 40 years, they have evolved to include or allow medications inside the therapeutic community, as well as they have started incorporating every positive or evidence-based strategy which helps the individual to change. Coming to the change in the duration side, the funding realities actually has cut down from almost from 18 to 24 months of the program to really nearly 3 to 6 months of program as such. Also, the professional staffing. Earlier, it has been just run by the peer counselors or so-called recovering addicts. Over a period, therapeutic communities has recruited professional staffs to help the individuals. Also, there are literature showing the therapeutic communities have helped the special population like juveniles, correction homes have taken therapeutic communities as the model. All these modifications are therapeutic community ensured that the modifications are to enhance the therapeutic community purpose as such, but it never allowed these strategies to substitute itself or substitute the community as the method. They still maintain that community as the method as their unique concept of therapeutic community. The different types of therapeutic community programs has been classified as standard therapeutic community programs, modified programs, and the therapeutic community oriented programs. Standard therapeutic community programs are use community as a method as the primary mode of intervention. They are usually residential settings with longer planned duration of treatments. They are primarily client driven. The goal is planned as well as executed by the client itself. The modified TC programs adapt community as a method for special populations such as co-occurring disorders, criminal justice, substance abusers, and juveniles. Modified TC programs can be of in any settings like hospitals, in shelter homes, in prisons, in correction homes. The modified TC programs also incorporate strategies and services which are proven useful in addressing particular problems of the participants. The modified TC programs are client and staff driven. Next comes the TC oriented programs, which is we can't call it itself as a therapeutic community program as because it serves only less severe clients in short term residential or day treatment settings, as well as they use eclectic approach, that is combination of all approaches for the treatment. And they use select elements of therapeutic community, and it's primarily the professional driven. Coming to the effectiveness of therapeutic communities as such, the research show that therapeutic community admissions have poor profile in terms of severity of substance use, social deviance, and psychological symptoms, which never allows the literature to come to a conclusion. But even then, therapeutic community is an effective, cost-effective treatment for certain subgroups of substance abusers, particularly those with serious social and psychological problems in addition to their drug abuse. The length of the stay in the treatment and the participation in subsequent aftercare were consistent predictors of recovery status. There were differences exist between standard and modified therapeutic community programs in essential elements across the cultures, but that the similarities in elements outweigh the differences across cultures. In the recent past, the largest long-term outcome study of addiction treatment intervention to date, sponsored by NIDA, DADOS, the Drug Addiction Treatment Outcome Study, found therapeutic communities to be effective. The participants who showed improved behavior after 1 year continued to do so after 5 years, which was also true for other modalities studied by Hubbard. The outpatient or day treatment at therapeutic communities also showed increased positive outcomes for the patients with less severe problems. Even though dropout is a concern with all treatments of addiction, therapeutic communities are no exception. Dropout is most likely during the first few months of the treatment. Thank you.